morning, YouTube. Good morning, Zach.
Yeah, good morning. How y'all feeling? What's up?
It's kind of dark, but it's fine. I'm making avocado toast again. And we running late, so I gotta hurry up. We got work at 9. I got class at 9, so I could work at 9.
Ooh. Say hello to the family on you on FaceTime.
All right, you
got cash homes? Yeah, I'm about to drive to work.
Wait, you slept in?
No. I came here in the morning. He's taking me to class. She's about to go to the city. I'm about to go to the city too. So,
driving.
Fine.
So sweet, you don't have to be on the tree.
Honestly,
I didn't see this video.
Oh, these people that's trying to stop MTA today. They're about to do some wild stuff.
The people that's what? Trying to stop MTA?
Yeah, I gotta show you this video. Hold on.
Police!
Alright, we out.
Police!
I should give my camera a name, right?
Call your camera Stacy.
Alright, I brought Stacy out today. Alan. I didn't bring her out yesterday.
Harley.
Got French vanilla coffee. Stacey, how do you like your coffee? Zach doesn't usually eat coffee.
I keep saying
that. I said that yesterday too, you know. I was like, I ate coffee. I keep saying that. He doesn't usually drink coffee.
Post fast disorder. Most fast.
I need that energy. I had 3 cups of coffee yesterday, guys.
I had one.
That's it.
I'm energized.
Yeah, I bucked out.
Let's go! Energized. What's that looking like over there? 26 minutes to get to the city? Let's do it.
It's lit.
Really?
Damn, I was hoping a bit late for class.
Thought about going back?
Yeah. I tried once, but it didn't work out because it didn't when I was there. Because basically, this is how it goes. It's an umbrella, right? It's called this thing where like you work out in your house. It's an app.
Is that that big?
And that bike. Yeah. Okay. It's the bike. But I didn't know they had a whole office because they're so new. They're one of the advertisers for TV1. That's how I know all these advertisers, because I used to like plug them into the system for TV1. Peloton, we in the city with it. We in the city with it. Way to class. I'm running late, but y'all already know how I do. I'm stopping for food again because that's what I do, and I need coffee to get through this day because I don't have it. I don't know, I'm so tired, and it's Friday and I have class tomorrow, so I really need coffee. I already have one cup, I'm on my second, so I'm about to go to Dunkin' Donuts. What time it is? I stopped checking the time. Oh my gosh, is this open? Oh, okay. Damn, is there one around here? Oh, I just got mad hype. Thank you. That Dunkin' Donuts is freaking closed. Oh, I hate New York, bro. I was gonna walk into class with my camera, but I'm like, I'm mad late, and I'm walking in with my camera too. I'm ODing, so I'll catch back up with you guys. I'm out of class now. I feel mad sick because I had 3 cups of coffee, which I shouldn't have done. Oh, my stomach hurts. And now I'm going to Chick-fil-A, as usual. So yeah. Zach's picking me up too, which is good because I left my Metro card at home, but I got a ride to work and I'm getting a ride back to the Bronx. Oh, he's calling me. camera. I'm gonna get footage while I'm down here. And then my the Chick-fil-A bag ripped. He barely gave me a bag. I had to go to the store to get water. That cost like $4. But this is the only water I like that was there. I don't like the scented.
Instead of that, understand that the majority of songs and lyrics that your congregation is singing had a every hard time. Single week.
That was just a lot.
I think I might consume right now before I have
to. Okay.
You gonna do that
now? Yeah. Let's do it. Mukbang. Chick-fil-A. You don't know what a mukbang is? Oh, non-YouTubers. Yo, what kind of salad is this?
A petty one?
Really?
What is this?
Really, Chick-fil-A?
They only gave you two sauces?
What is this? Yeah, you want some more? Yeah. I got you the ask for more.
What are you gonna have sauce with your nuggets?
I have sauce.
Oh,
that's
okay.
You have one Chick-fil-A, one Poly Asian. I have one Chick-fil-A, one Poly Asian.
You gotta ask for all the sauces.
Huh? I only be using these two.
Yeah, me too. You to get a whole bunch.
Oh, so why are you? Why
I
are
get
you
a, I get a whole bunch because I like dipping my Chick-fil-A and I dip my. I dip my burger in my chicken sandwich.
Oh, you're one of those people.
You double dip doubling.
It's Friday.
All right, let's talk about something interesting and entertaining for my channel.
I cut this and it started over.
You what?
Cut this and started over.
That's easy. Something interesting. We talk about God. We could talk about our damn fast.
The fast.
We could talk about.
It's really crazy how God was
living in New York City.
Was not jacking my music during the fast.
Oh, he did.
Remember, I was trying to record it all those times, and he was just not now. What is that?
Salad dressing. I just want to make sure that's not spilling.
You want to put it in the bag?
Yeah. So, for those of you who don't know, Zach is a singer-songwriter, and he used to make mostly like R&B, regular music, but now he makes like more gospel.
I make music for God.
Yeah.
Because gospel, I don't like when people say gospel, because gospel is a genre, and we always like categorize music that's like faith-based and gospel. When it's like
true.
It's different because you know you have gospel music. Gospel music is like a genre, like Kirk Franklin, Donnie McKirkland, Tasha Cobbs. That's gospel. But then you have like Hillsong, which is like worship.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, that's true.
You got Eshawn Burgundy and Jay Monty. They're neither gospel or worship. They're rap, hip hop, but it's Christian rap.
Look at them wearing the mask. But yeah, so that's what he's talking about when he said. God wasn't jacking his music during the fast.
Yeah, I tried to like when I wrote the songs, one of the songs before the fast happened. Then I wrote another and that other song I wrote it during the fast. But basically during the time I was fasting, I was trying to set up a studio appointment to schedule and write the first song. And I recorded the studio all the time. Like they did my whole first Humble Heart EP. So I remember calling one day we was at our friend's Woods house eating some Daniel Fast approved food. And I was calling the studio to try to schedule an appointment. I called like three times and the number went straight to like this busy, this, like voicemail. Whatever. I think on the second time when I called, the number like did that weird thing. It was like, oh, this number's out of service. I'm like, wait, what? It's crazy. But then so I waited like 10, 15 minutes. Called back again. I didn't get no answer. And then when I got the answer, bro told me that he had no studio appointments for like that whole week. I'm like, what? Wow. Copy. Also, at first I'm being naive. I'm like, maybe it's a sign from God, maybe it's not. Whatever. And like a week later, I tried to set up another appointment again. I was at my house and I tried to call to set up an appointment. This is in the week too. And they told me they had no appointment set up. I'm like, what? Like you don't have no space throughout a whole week. So my Monday through Friday, you feel me? The studio be open up from 10 a.m. to like 4, 5 a.m. They had no time for me. So I'm like, this is God. Like, gotta be God telling me, like, yo, finish your fast, stay faithful to me. And you're gonna be, you know, you're gonna make it in my time. Best believe, when I finished the fast, I pulled the studio, set the appointment up, they got time for me. So yesterday, we went to the studio, and I recorded some fuego.
Which is in our vlog from yesterday.
It's going on.
But why do you think that's God?
I believe it's God because, for one, I never had a problem recording any song. Every studio session I wanted to go to, I've always been able to do it. And then the fact with the number going out of service randomly.
That's true.
Where did that happen at?
That's true. It's weird.
That's what I said. And then 5 minutes after that, when it says out of service, it goes back in service. That don't happen. Not with no landline phones. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
That's God. And then just the effect that it has on people that's hearing the song.
That's true.
I had a friend that cried.
What do you hearing the song. It?
I have people like really just like, yo, this song is a hit. This song is amazing. It's crazy. And
Christians and non-Christians.
Yeah, and I don't want like any kudos for this, because at the end of the day, it ain't me and it's not for me. It's for God and giving Him glory. And for people out there that, you know, don't know how much God loves them, but they need to understand and they need to see it. So I can be real with them. Be real with them, you know what I'm saying?
Mm. Yeah.
And I finished these large fries and that sandwich, and I'm still hungry.
You could have some of my nuggets.
No, I'm about to see what this milkshake do.
Oh yeah, I forgot you had that.
This garbage over there?
Yeah. So what was the biggest thing that you learned on the fast? You can only pick one thing.
Biggest thing? What do you mean, like important? I learned like a lesson?
Yeah. Like something you didn't know before.
I wouldn't say I didn't know before. I would say something I really realized. That it's like a compound answer, but like God's love is truly unconditional, and there's really nothing you can do that can separate you from Him or make Him love you any less than He already does love you. You just gotta come to terms in it and receive it. What about you?
I think for me, I really learned about God's grace. Mm-hmm. Because during the fast, I kind of always felt like if I did. I'm not saying just during the fast, I'm talking about in general, period. If I did, the more I read the Bible, the more I went to church, the more I engaged. Yo, my camera's really a hater, bro. First the battery, then the space. Like I was saying before, I got cut off. What the heck? Oh, anyways. Let me say what I gotta say, and then I can end the video. So, like I was saying. Like I was saying,
like you were saying, what?
I'm recording a YouTube video, bro. I'm at work. Like,
I'm actually greasy. I just had some Chick-fil-A. I'm feeling extra nasty, but it's Chick-fil-A and I love it.
Look at it. Would you look at it? We got,
I just got off of work.
Got the poly.
And she was right next to it.
Gang, gang.
Where you at?
I don't know if I'm finished what I was saying.
Huh?
I'm just putting in the description box what I learned during my damn
class. What happened to her?
Haters want to interrupt me.
She's okay. She just has to do a nose surgery.
Who?
What?
Wait, what?
Who?
I'm about to pass out.
What do you mean, Kai?
Kai?
Yeah.
Really?
What do you mean? For what? I'm getting off the phone. I'm gonna holler at y'all when I get uptown. Where you at? Where you at?
She didn't realize it's printed numbers, and that's what the devil wants. He wants y'all to always feel alone.
Yeah. Where you at? Where you at? Where you at?
She's not doing it today. She's doing it next week, Friday.
What kind?
What time? But like I was saying before, I was interrupted.
Cash and Fatima, we have to like explain jokes to them because they're like. If I'm like,
they don't know me by Cash. My name's Nahima.
Oh, Nahima. Sorry. Sorry. Nahima and Fatima, which is here on the phone. I hope you guys, all right. She,
we are.
They don't get jokes that New Yorkers you normally get. They've been away for a little while when they went away to college and they've adapted to like Pennsylvania language and lingo.
Ooh, that's not funny.
That's funny. She did hung up. So I was about to answer back.
Anyways, she calling back. Why is my phone only ringing?
You're kind of you personally, that's why.
I think that's a group call though.
Nah, that's good.
Like I was saying to y'all before, I was interrupted not once but twice. So I was saying that during my damn fast, I really learned about God's grace, because long story short, during the fast, it wasn't about what you couldn't eat or could eat, right? It was about spending intentionally spending more time with God.
Yes, sir.
And that was cool, chilling with God more. Like he told me, and it was. It was also about making room for God. It wasn't just about spending more time with him, but making room for him. And what that means is taking out things that don't serve him or kind of hinder you from spending time with him. Taking them out for like a little while, whether it's like food or Instagram or Netflix or whatever. And then replacing that time with God. And that really makes a difference. So it was cool. I heard things. I feel like I really had like a clear connection with him. More so than other times, because I'm not gonna lie, sometimes the connection seemed kind of fuzzy. But during the fast, it was pretty clear, and yeah, I focused on my vision. Look, I learned a lot.
Man.
Fuck, I heard a lot of God's voice.
That's a fact.
Like, some mornings, I just woke up hearing his voice. It was like weird stuff that he was saying. I didn't really understand, but it was nice to hear his voice.
The scriptures that we used to get up, because we were getting up at like 5:30 to pray and read. Like that was something that was just really beneficial.
Yeah, that's
getting
true.
Up early in the morning to intentionally seek God and seek his will and seek him. And then when you're getting a word and the word is hitting you, or the word sticks to you for the day, it's like, wow. Because you know, God speaks in multiple ways, but one of the main ways he speaks is through his word.
Yeah.
But thanks to God, man. Thanks be to God, man. If you don't believe, it's okay. He still loves you. And if you believe, then you know. But grace is sufficient. There's new mercies every day, new grace every day. And as long as you're breathing, living, you can be reconciled with God. You just gotta believe.
And on that note, we out.
You gotta get out
and talk about them when they don't listen. If you lie on your taxes, all of those things are forms of worship submitted to me if they're done with the right heart. And so I realized, like when I treat my wife right, I'm worshiping God.
Hey y'all, I'm home. I was taking a nap. Not really. I took a nap in the car. We were on our way uptown. Then I got home. I was trying to take a nap, but I couldn't. So I just studied for a little bit. But then I got tired of that. I was reading, studying on Instagram. But now I'm about to edit this video, post it, and then I have a meeting at church. So, and yeah, I'm here watching Queen. So I'm about to do that while I edit my video. And better luck tomorrow. Bye.
Hold on, I got more. I know my life can get so crazy, but as long as you're right here, none of the gossip, nothing can stop.